Good morning. My name is Joe Lauer, and I'm with the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'm the corn agronomist for the state of Wisconsin, and today what I'm going to talk about is corn growth and development and the physiology of grain yield and kind of where grain yield and silage yield comes from. If you look back, we have records in Wisconsin, much of the U.S., for corn yield way back to 1866. And if you look at the corn yield progress that occurred up until the 1930s, there really wasn't much. If you look at the slope, it was basically zero. But with the advent of hybrid corn in the 1930s, we started to see a yield increase of 1.7 bushels per acre. There have been a number of reasons why and technologies as to why we've seen these yield increases, everything from the hybrids, but also fertilizer, pesticide use, things like that. But in 1996, another major step occurred where we started to grow transgenic hybrids within the U.S. And since that time, we've seen a yield increase of 2.4 bushels per acre per year in the U.S. In Wisconsin, the rates of increase haven't been quite as much, but they still are very positive and ranging from about 1.5 to 2 bushels per acre per year has been the yield increase. Now, some of the projections that have been made are that we will, by the year 2030, we will be producing corn at about 300 bushels per acre average, and that would mean we'd have to increase corn production about 6.5 bushels per acre per year. This projection was made in 2007, and we haven't really kept on that trend line, but it's quite a goal to try to get to that point. But one of the things that's been happening is that although every U.S. county has significantly increased corn yields since 1930, there's a lot of spatial and temporal variability that exists for large regions of the U.S. This map kind of shows that, where it's just the last 20 years from 1990 to 2009, that basically shows a rate of yield increase for corn across the U.S. Much of the yield increase has been occurring in the central Corn Belt area, where they've been enjoying about a 3 to 4 bushel per acre per year increase or more. But there are large areas in Kansas, Virginia, the eastern side of the country, where there really haven't been much yield increases since 1990. And this slide really is just to point that out a little bit about this spatial variability that occurs. In Wisconsin, especially along the northern Corn Belt, we haven't seen as much yield increase as the southern part of the state. So to get to this 300 bushel per acre per year goal, one of the things that another measure of yield is kind of what some of the top producers are doing in Wisconsin. This slide shows the yield increase that's occurred for various yield contests that are ongoing in Wisconsin going back to the 1980s. We've got two major groups. One is the PEPS contest, the other is the NCGA yield contest, and you can see that on average, some of these growers and these top growers in these programs are producing 4 to 4.5 bushels per acre per year within these contests. So they're approaching this goal of 300 bushels per acre per year down the road. But today, what I'd like to do today, more than anything, is just talk about some keys to profitable corn production, to talk a little bit about how a corn plant grows and develops and go through one life cycle, if you will, where we can kind of pinpoint some practices that are essential for production. And the questions I want to answer are: how does healthy corn grow and develop in Wisconsin? When is yield determined during the life cycle of corn? And what abiotic factors influence yield, and what, if anything, can we do about them? A lot of what I'm going to talk about today doesn't necessarily put money in your pocket, but it helps you to understand what's going on in the field, especially as it relates to yield. And not only that, but it'll help you interpret what happened at the end of the season as to what your management practices, how they impacted yield during the growing season. If I was to list kind of the major things to be very careful and watchful for as you as you grow corn, this would be my list. This list has changed over the years, but I think this is probably the main things to be concentrating on. A big part of growing corn is growing the right hybrid, and increasingly more and more, the hybrids we picked dictate the management that occurs later on. For example, a lot of the insecticide traits that are available in corn hybrids will affect how you manage insects later on in the season. It all comes down to, though, the cost of production and economics. And getting a handle on that, again, is very important for profitability. That's where it really all starts. Seed treatments help you set up your season. A lot of the decisions that corn growers make are really made at the time of planting, and that's where you really need to spend a lot of your time deciding about which hybrid to grow, seed treatment to put on that seed, what seeding rate should you have out there, and just being ready to plant corn in a timely fashion, because if you get delayed there, you tend to be delayed later on the season as well. In these last couple seasons, that's what many growers have experienced in Wisconsin. Of course, eliminating pests, especially weeds, is a major priority as you get into in-season decisions. Nitrogen and soil fertility is important. Rotation is one of those decisions that's kind of free yield. Anytime you can rotate corn, we know that you'll see a yield increase of around 10 to 20% just with that decision. However, the economics sometimes dictate that you probably grow some continuous corn on some fields. And then finally, harvesting and storing carefully. In most years, we can get by with that, but we do have years where it can be very difficult to harvest in a timely manner. One of the other things, though, that has really been, I think, more and more of an issue for growers lately has been just managing all the information that's available during the season. And there's a lot of information that comes not only from extension, but also from industry, co-ops, various places. And managing all that information is becoming a real struggle, I think, for growers, especially when you get into yield mapping and various precision farming technologies that are available. And so I think getting a handle on some of this is also an important aspect to good corn yield and profitability. Well, let's kind of go through some of these questions and get at the economics a little bit. The first thing I'd like to cover is how much does it cost to grow an acre of corn or a bushel of corn in Wisconsin? And this slide here kind of shows what it's been costing within the PEPS program through the years. And the cost per acre is right over here. And you can see that up until about 2006 or 7 or so, it was ranging between $250 and $350 an acre to grow corn. But beginning about 2009 and certainly through 2011, that cost of production increased dramatically. And right now we figure that it's between about $500 and $600 an acre to grow corn. We'll see what this lower price does now and how that relates to some of the input costs that go on. But certainly the cost of producing an acre of corn has gone up substantially. If you look at the USDA Wisconsin average annual corn price, though, it's been relatively low for quite a few years. There were a few spikes. 1995, there was a little bit of a spike. And then recently, there's been more of a spike. We've enjoyed some very good prices. And so when you look at the cost per the price per bushel and then the cost per bushel, and this is, again, data from PEPS, the cost per bushel is ranging between $1.50 and about $2.50 per bushel. So this difference here is the profit that is available to growers. Now, many of the growers in PEPS enjoy very good yields. So if we, instead of using good yields, and we just use average yields, this would be then the difference, if you will, between the average yields and the price received. And you can see that profitability or that distance between these two lines is quite a bit lower. But we've seen some good profitability the last few years. unlike the 1990s and 1980s, where oftentimes the cost per bushel was very tough to meet that price per bushel. So as you start to break down these costs then, where do some of these costs kind of fall in? And this slide will just go through six different areas. The first one is seed here. And you can see how much seed has increased. It's probably the one input that's increased the most over the last 20 to 30 years. In the late 1980s and early 1990s, it was running about $20 an acre for seed. And now we're up over $80 to almost $100 an acre nowadays. So that increased basically 4 to 5 times over that 20-year period. Another big input has been fertilizer, and that's gone up about 3x. In the 1980s and 90s, it was running about $40 to $50 or so, and now we're up around $140 to $150 an acre for fertilizer. Chemicals in corn production really haven't changed all that much. They average around $20 to $25. Harvesting, again, we have some spikes with harvesting, and these spike years are typically years where you've got tremendous drying costs associated with it. And one of the worst was 2009, where we had tremendous drying costs associated with growing corn in that particular year. Almost 90 cents to a dollar a bushel just in that particular year. Equipment has gone up recently, but it's about $40 to $50 early. Now it's about $60 to $70. And of course, land is probably the hardest to capture in terms of costs, but it as well has gone up. And I think we underestimate how much the land costs are within this PEPS program. I think many growers, especially in the southern part of the state, are oftentimes paying $200 or more per acre for renting corn ground. So, but this gives you kind of a little bit of a breakdown and kind of where the major shifts have gone on in input costs in the production of corn. One of the things that I like to impress upon growers is setting realistic goals when they grow corn. And one way to do that is just look at what have been the top yields in your county. The record corn production county is actually in the central part of the state, in Portage County, at 327 bushels per acre. This was on an irrigated site during 2012, a drought year. We've also had good yields recorded in Grant County, of course, and most of the higher yields are in the southern part of the state. But just knowing what that upper potential is for commercial production fields, I think, is an important step in being realistic, at least, as to what your yield goal should be as you try to manage corn. And these are, again, the record performances that we've seen using the PEPS contest as well as the NCGA contest. All right, so that gives you a little bit of a feel then for the cost of production. Now what I'd like to move into is what I just call growth and development of corn. And understanding this will go a long ways towards just managing that corn crop, especially as it relates to yield.